Hello students, in this video I am going to explain you how you can determine the value of V3 using Thevenin theorem. So for the Thevenin theorem you need to determine the value of RTH, Thevenin resistance, VTH, so that after that you can determine the current and voltage that is passing through this load resistor and the voltage that is there across this load resistor. Over here the value of RL, it will be 40 ohm because we need to determine the V3 across 40 ohm. So to solve this, first of all let us determine the value of this VTH. So to determine the value of this VTH, what we have done, we simply remove the load resistor and then our task will be to determine the value of this VOC, which will be equal to V3, and this VOC will be nothing but our VTH also. So in this equation, like you can, in this circuit you can see that we have two loops. One is this one, let the loop current over here, let it be I1, and another loop current is this, and let the loop current be I2. Now from the second loop, means I2 loop, you can see that we have a current dependent source, and the value of the current dependent source, it is 15 I1, where I1 is this. Okay, so it means that directly I can write the value of I2 equals to minus 15 I1, or capital I1, because my I1 and this I1, they are same. So I can write it is minus 15 I1. Minus sign is there because the direction of I2 and the direction of the dependent current source, they are opposite to each other. So we get our first equation. After that we can write a KVL equation for loop 1. And to write a KVL equation, the effective current in this 10 ohm, it will be I1. Effective current in this 20 ohm, it will be I1 will go in this direction, I2 will go in opposite direction. So effective current, it will be I1 minus I2. For this 30 ohm, since this circuit over here, this circuit is open, so only effective current through it will be I1. So writing the KVL equation, we will get 80 equals to 10 I1 plus 20 I1 minus I2 plus 30 I1. Substituting the value of this I2 in this equation, I can get 80 equals to 10 plus 20 I1 plus 30 I1 means 60 I1 plus minus 20 I2. Now in place of I2, I can put the value of I2, means minus 15 I1. And with this, I can determine the value of I1 as 4 by 18, as 2 by 9 ampere. Now to determine the value of this VOC or VTH, you can see that this VTH, it is this node, this VTH, it is in parallel with this branch. So VTH can be expressed as plus is over here. So if we will write 30 plus, now over here sign, here it will be plus, here it will be minus, so it will be minus 10 I1, and over here it is plus and minus, so it will be plus 80. So it will be 110 minus 10 I1 Substituting the value of this 2 by 9 in this, I will get, and the value of VTH, it is come, it will be 970 upon 9 volt. So this 970 upon 9 volt, it is going to be my VTH. Now next we need to determine the value of RTH. To determine the value of RTH, what we need to do? We need to deactivate all the independent sources, and then we need to keep the dependent source as it is. And to determine the RTH, what we can do? We can, over here, we will put a current source of 1 ampere. Like this. I will put a source of 1 ampere over here, and then if I determine this voltage across this 1 ampere, then my RTH, it will be this V3 upon current is 1 ampere, so I will get RTH as equals to V3. So whatever value of the V3 that I am going to obtain, that will be my Thevenin resistance. So with this circuit, now my task will be to calculate the V3. So to calculate V3, what I can do, again I can assume a loop currents. So one loop current is this I1, let the loop current in this be I2, let the loop current in this be I3. Now once again, I2 and the current source, they are opposite to each other, plus in this current source, through this current source we have one I2 that is flowing opposite to the current dependent source, and we also have I3. So it means now the effective current that is flowing through the dependent source, it is going to be I3 minus I2 equals to 15 I1, because the effective current that is flowing through the dependent current source, it is I3 minus I2. So now I3, you can see that in this particular branch only I3 current is there, and since we have a current source of 1 ampere over here, so a value of I3, it will be minus 1, because the direction of the current source and I3, they are opposite to each other. Substituting this value of I3 in this equation, I will get 15 I1 minus plus I2 is equals to minus 1. So this is going to be my first equation. After that, let me write a KVL equation for loop 1. So for loop 1, you can see that over here the effective current will be I1, over here effective current will be I1 minus I2, and over here effective current will be I1 minus I3, and plus minus plus minus plus minus. So now if I write equation, I will get 10 I1 plus 20 I1 minus I2 plus 30 I1 minus I3 equal to 0. Solving this equation, I will get 60 I1 minus 20 I2 plus minus 30 I3 equals to 0, or 6 I1 minus 2 I2 minus 3 I3 is equals to 0. Now substituting the value of this I3 is minus 1, so substituting that value, I will get 6 I1 minus 2 I2 equals to 3, equals to minus 3. Okay, so this is going to be my second equation, and you can see now I have two equations and two unknowns So solving this equation, I will get the value of I1 as minus 5 by 36. And similarly, I can get the value of I2. Now, since my task is to determine this V3, and if you see that this V3, this potential across this branch, it will be equal to the potential across this, means the potential across 10 ohm, that will be the potential across this V3 with the direction of the polarity reverse, because over here it is plus and over here it is minus. So our V3, it will be equals to minus 10 I1. So since we got the value of I1 as minus 5 by 36, so substituting this value over here, I will get 50 upon 36 equals to 25 by 18. And since our RTH is equals to V3, we get this over here. So it means that my RTH is equals to 25 by 18 ohm. So substituting this value over here, now easily I can determine the value of I, means I will be equals to VTH upon RTH plus RL. Substituting all this value, VTH, RTH, RL, I will get the value something as 1940 upon 745 ampere. And the voltage across RL, it will be 40 I, so it will be something this. So means overall only task is to determine the value of RTH and VTH, and once we get it, simply we can determine the current and the voltage that is there across the load resistance. So with this, I end this video. If you have any doubt, you can put it in the comment box, and do subscribe my channel. Thank you.